watching New York One News all morning.
Thanks for joining us this morning. There is a fresh blanket of snow on the ground today, but it's not the snow that's got New Yorkers talking. It's what's in the snow. There are dinosaur tracks along West 81st Street. Here's the remarkable video. These appear to be Tyrannosaurus Rex tracks, and they lead straight to the Museum of Natural History.
Now that we seem to be back, let's recap some of the frightening developments.
American Airways.
Superheroes in New York? Give me a break.
These so-called heroes.
Our coverage on this breaking story begins with New York One's Jessica Abo at the scene.
That's right. We're standing here with two eyewitnesses who are going to tell us what they just saw.
Retiring Police Commissioner Charles Stanford and his predicted successor, Captain Marion Mathers, are coming under continued scrutiny for the quality of life raid here at the Queensborough Projects on Christmas Eve. Locals are saying this didn't have a whole lot to do with safer streets, and had a lot more to do with real estate, a deal to turn the coveted waterfront property into condos.
The big question, will the U.S. defy Russia?
The horrific twist is that the hijacker is now believed to be the one person who was authorized to carry a gun onto the plane.
A woman in the Bronx killed her husband and then turned the gun on herself. The woman left a note by the scene saying just one line. This is something I just wanted to do for myself.
Yesterday, Senate hopeful Chris Marshall was captured on videotape in a lover's spat with a woman now identified as a hotel maid.
Come on, who's kidding who here? Do you think you would have taken a second look at me if you knew I was the maid?
We were talking a lot here in the newsroom about how to deal with these final minutes. I've been in this chair bringing you the news literally thousands of times. Honestly, I don't want to spend my final minute on Earth here. We want the people who work here to be with their loved ones. There was a spirit in New York after the September 11th terrorist attacks that was about caring and giving. We have seen that again today under these unimaginably tragic circumstances. Al Gore was right. By the time we realized what we'd done, we had already ruined the planet, and today it doesn't matter where you live or how much money you have, we are all about to face the same fate at the same moment. My family's waiting for me now. There's nothing more for us to say here but to repeat what we have told you. We don't have much time left. You don't need me to sit here and tell you how tragic this is. So this is the end of our commentary. We are going to fill the screen with live camera views from all over the city, and we will leave those pictures up until the end.